The future of energy lies in clean, renewable energy without a doubt. How do thermal batteries fit into the future of renewable energy? Each year, renewable energy makes up more of the total energy produced throughout the world. Apart from hydroelectric energy, renewable energy sources such as solar energy and wind energy are among the most commonly used. Due to being intermittent energy sources, it cannot be utilized to its full potential yet. The sun does not always shine and the wind is not always blowing. If this intermittent energy can be stored, it can be employed even during times during which the sources are not actively providing energy. What is thermal energy storage? It can be shortly described as storing energy as heat or cold in a storage medium to be used later to produce power or using it for heating or cooling purposes. Thermal energy storage's main use is to overcome the imbalance between energy generation and energy use. A few essential requirements for an effective thermal energy storage system is a storage material with a high energy density, very good insulation to ensure minimal heat loss, a storage material that is chemically stable, as well as a completely reversible process that can be repeated numerous times. From here on forward, a thermal energy storage system will be referred to as a thermal battery. There is three main thermal energy storage types. Sensible heat storage, dealing with a mild increase or decrease in the temperature of a storage material. Latent heat storage, which involves the phase change of a storage material. And thermochemical energy storage, where a reversible chemical reaction with high energy involved is used to store energy. Latent heat storage is the focus of this video, choosing the phase change material that stores the energy as heat and release it once cooled is a crucial parameter. What is the ideal phase change material? Second to oxygen, this material is the most abundant element in the Earth's crust. Each material unit area can store 2.3 times more energy than a lithium-ion battery, 10 times more than lead-acid batteries, and 7.3 times that of nickel-cadmium batteries. This mystery material is roughly 75% the cost of a lithium-ion battery of the same size. This mysterious material is silicon and is ideal to use as the storage material, with silicon having a melting point of roughly 1400 degrees Celsius. To change its phase from a solid to a liquid will require a lot of energy. What are the complications of this theoretical solution? To fully operate as a battery, the system should be able to charge and discharge. Thus, energy will be transferred from electrical to thermal and back to electrical energy. Energy losses and energy conversions go hand in hand, and how this is approached will greatly influence the efficiency of the thermal battery. Will this solution be implemented? Two Australian companies, CCT Energy Storage and 1414 Degrees, have been working independently on utilizing this concept of thermal battery to store thermal energy and use it to rationalize the energy demand and shave the peak loads. The former mentioned released a fully operational thermal battery in early April 2019, whereas the latter are busy with testing. According to 1414 Degrees, unit costs fall as energy capacity scales up. CCT stated that scaling the battery down to be used in smartphones, laptops, and electric vehicles are not plausible, as a large volume of silicon is required to reach the optimal energy density. Both companies claim that silicon does essentially not degrade over time as with lithium-ion batteries, therefore resulting in additional cost decrease when compared to a traditional battery setup. Thermal energy batteries shows immense potential and will definitely play a vital role in the future of renewable energy. The future holds many mysteries, and I am sure in the coming years we will see many remarkable advancements in battery and energy storing technologies. If you have any topics that you would like to see discussed on Genius Engineering, let me know in the comments. If you did find the video entertaining and informative, be sure to click like and subscribe for more insight into interesting topics.